deliverance service, and I want you to stay connected with us, because as we seek his face in prayer, I see God causing a change in our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I love the song. All of you know what we are going through in the world now. There is chaos everywhere. There is no safe place again. There is no place that is safe again. Usually people will tell you that they are going abroad to go and get rest. The place they used to go for rest is restless now. The people who live in the place the people used to go and get rest, their lives are now full of stress. That is to tell you that the only place we can have security is in Christ. Oh, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. He said, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. There is no safe place any longer except you are in Christ. And for that reason, we refuse to be silent. We refuse to be quiet. We give our worship unto him each and every day. As long as we are breathing, we will always worship him. Wherever you are, lift up your hand one more time. If you are sitting down, lift up your right hand. And one more time, make that your declaration. Make a pledge, make a vow that, Lord, I will not be silent. Even in this pandemic, I will not be silent. I still recognize you as my God. I am alive today because of you. My family is what it is today because of your grace and your mercy. We are what we are by the grace of God. Because of your unfailing love, we are what we are today. We will not be silent. We will worship you forevermore. As long as we are alive, as long as we are breathing, we will give our worship unto you. Kingsman Redeemer, we bless you. Mighty man of war, we glorify you. El Shaddai, we magnify you. None before you, none besides you. Let your name forever be glorified. Take all the glory and praise. Take all the honor tonight. Speak to our hearts tonight. Open our eyes to what we need to know. Give us understanding. Let your word bring an illumination of light into our hearts. Let your word give us direction tonight. And as we cry unto you in prayer, may you respond to our prayers tonight. Cause a change in the life of somebody that is watching now. Cause a change in somebody that is concentrating and waiting for you for that change. Do your work in our lives, and all the glory will return to you. Be glorified forever, God. In Jesus' mighty name of prayer.
Amen.
One more time, take your seat. God bless you again. I want to welcome you tonight. We are going to share God's word, very brief, and then we are going to pray tonight. Like I always say, I want to say it again tonight, that in every deliverance session, there are two major components you find. Whenever somebody is talking of deliverance, don't just run to a church that claims to be a deliverance church. Don't just run to a pastor that claims to be a deliverance pastor. Two major components you must find in every deliverance session. Number one is the word of God, the word. If the word is absent, deliverance cannot be complete. When the word is missing, deliverance can never be complete. Bible says that the word of God is quick and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword. The word of God. So wherever you go, and they say they are in for deliverance session, and you can't find the word, just know that that deliverance is not complete. And number two is prayer. Somebody say prayer.
Prayer.
Come on, somebody say prayer.
Prayer.
The second component you must always see in every deliverance session is prayer. No matter how the word is being preached, no matter what people will tell you that is written in the word, the next thing you must be ready for is prayer. And I believe that as you receive God's word tonight and we enter into a session of prayer, may your deliverance be complete in Jesus' mighty name. I want to share tonight, ladies and gentlemen, on the subject I titled, When God is Involved. When God is Involved. Let me begin tonight, ladies and gentlemen, by saying that life is full of stress when God is absent. Life is full of difficulty and challenges when God is absent. You know, when I was growing up as a young man, I used to think that happiness or happy people on earth are the richest. Those who are wealthy, I used to think that they are the most happy people. I used to feel that when you have a good car, when you have a good job, I used to think that when you are married to a beautiful woman, your life will automatically be happy. But as I get matured in God, I have come to a conclusion that success and peace of mind is not determined by your bank account. Peace of mind and success is not subject to what you claim you have. Bible says a man's life does not consist in the abundance of the things that he possesses. Your life is not consist on the things that you claim you have. When God is absent, life can be miserable. You can be rich but stress. You can be rich but yet your life is full of stress. You can be wealthy but yet you are empty. There are many wealthy people I have met in life, but you pity them because you know that with all the wealth they carry, their lives are empty. My prayer for you tonight is that you will not just be wealthy in when it comes to finance, you will be wealthy in God in Jesus' name. May you not just be rich in substance, but may you be rich in the word of God in the name of Jesus. What guarantees fulfillment in life is having God in your matter. What makes you complete is when God is in your matter. What makes your life complete is when God decides to be with you. And my prayer for somebody again tonight is that whatever your family is going through this year, whatever you are going through in this second half of the year, may God back you up in the name of Jesus. Amen. And I also want to let you know that the best that life can offer is still not enough minus God. I take my time to say what I'm saying. The best that life can offer is still not enough when God is absent. Minus God, no matter what you think you have, you are still not secure. Many people try to look for happiness here on earth, leaving God behind. And hear me well. There is a vacuum in the life of every man that nothing can fill except Jesus. There is a space, there is a vacuum in the life of man that nobody can ever fill except the man called Jesus. Let me pause and make this statement to somebody that is watching me. I've had people saying that they will be complete when they are married. I've had people saying that they will be satisfied with life when they have a child. Lo and behold, after marriage, their lives are still full of stress. Lo and behold, the child that we are craving to have is around now. Yet, the vacuum is still in their lives. There is a space in you that nothing else can fill except you run to Jesus. Only those who remain in God can be the best that life can offer. If you are not in God, you can never be the best that life can offer you. So tonight, I want to encourage you. My message tonight, I said, is when God is involved. I want to encourage you that no matter what you want to do, no matter the step you want to take, involve God in your matter. May you involve God in every matter in Jesus' name. Amen. Today you go around, you meet many bad marriages. You meet people who are married, but they are full of regrets. Why? Because they never involved God before they got into the marriage. And I keep telling people that not all that glitters is gold. You can meet a beautiful lady, and in your heart of hearts, you think, oh, I found my own. I think this can be a wife to me. Little did you know that you should not judge the book by its cover. When God is involved in your matter, life can be complete. One more time, I pray for 14 people watching at me. May God be involved in every of your matter in the name of Jesus. From tonight, every step you want to take in life, may you be able to involve God in it in the name of Jesus. When God is involved,
four, I want to show you four major things that will happen to your life.
And then we pray. Lift up your hand wherever you are. Say, my God, my Father. Come on, talk to me. Say, my God, my Father. Say, as I pray tonight, from tonight, every step I take, every move I make, may you be involved in my matter. From tonight, every decision of my life, may you be involved in it, in the name of Jesus. Four major things I will show you tonight that happens when God is involved. Are you ready for them tonight? We'll run through them and then we'll pray. Number one, four things that happens to a man when God is involved in your matter. Number one, when God is involved in your matter, results will cancel insult. Results will cancel insult. He said in his word that for your trouble you shall receive double. When God is involved in the matter of a man, the result in your life will quiet your enemies. People who said it will never happen, you don't need to be arguing with them. You don't need to try to defend your life to them. Go for results in God. When your life carries result, every insult around you will be quieted. I don't know how many people are trying to insult you because of your service to God. I don't know what you are trusting God for that they said will never happen. But after tonight, as you involve God in that your matter tonight, let the result in your life cancel every insult in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That was what happened in 1 Samuel chapter 1. Bible told us about a woman by the name of Anna. She was barren. Anna was barren. Peninnah was insulting her because she could not give birth to a child. She was mocked by her mates because there was no child. But when God decided to step into the matter of Hannah, when God decided to step into Hannah's matter, aged barrenness was converted to fruitfulness. There is somebody that is watching at me. I pray for you. I pray for you today. Every form of barrenness in your life, may it be converted to fruitfulness in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say every form of barrenness in your life, every cause of barrenness in your life, whatever has caused your life to be barren, let it be converted to fruitfulness in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When God involved in the matter of Hannah, the story became something else. Her barrenness was converted to divine fruitfulness. The prophet Eli said to Hannah that by this time next year, when God is involved, it will take a word from the mouth of a pastor. It will take a word from the mouth of your prophet to change your condition. Eli looked at Hannah that was barren all this while. And the man of God said to her, by this time next year. I don't know who is watching at me that is trusting God for a child. I don't know who is watching at me that is believing God for that kind of a miracle that Hannah was trusting God for. I stand in the position of Eli and I prophesy like Eli prophesied. I pray for you like Eli prayed for Hannah, that by this time next year, may you carry your child in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May you be a mother to your own child in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When God is involved, results will cancel insults. Results will cancel insults. Number two, the second thing that happens when God is involved. Number two, when God is involved, your toiling, your labor will come to an end. Your toiling, your labor will come to an end. Listen to me, somebody. There are many of you that is watching at me now. The way you labor, it is not reflecting in your life. The way you work hard and the kind of result you get, they don't look alike. The reason is because God is not involved in your matter. Luke chapter 5.
from verse 1. Luke chapter 5 from verse 1. Jesus came to a place and met a man by the name of Peter. Look at what the Bible says. Luke chapter 5. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret. And Jesus saw two ships standing by the lake. He said, but the fishermen, we are gone out of them, and we are washing their nets. And Jesus entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down, and Jesus taught the people out of the ship. Bible says, now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught. Look at what Peter said. Simon Peter said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. He said, but nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. And the rest of the story was a great catch. The same place where Peter toiled the whole of the night and they caught nothing. When Jesus stepped into the matter, there is somebody that is watching at me now. Jesus is stepping into your family matter. I said, Jesus is stepping into your marital matter. Jesus is stepping into your childbearing matter. If you are the one I'm talking to, shout a louder amen.
Amen.
Your toiling comes to an end. Peter said, we have toiled the whole of the night, and yet we caught nothing. Jesus looked at Simon, and Jesus said to him, the problem why you could not get any catch was because I was not around. I can't be in the family, and you are called a barren woman. I can't be in that marriage, and you are talking about divorce. No way! Jesus said to Peter, launch into the deep. Thank God, Peter obeyed. Peter said, nevertheless, I don't know how many times you have tried for that miracle and it has not been coming. I don't know how many times you have prayed for that particular breakthrough and it has not been coming. I want you to behave like Peter did. And Peter said, nevertheless, at thy word. It takes a word. It takes a word for a change. Therefore, I come with that word that will cause your life to experience a change. I come with that word that will cause a change in your family. By this time next year, may your family be fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
By this time next year, let there be an addition to your family in the name of Jesus. When God is involved, your toiling, your labor will come to an end. Your labor will come to an end. I see God showing up for somebody in Jesus' name. I say, I see Jehovah showing up for somebody in the name of Jesus. I see God stepping into that matter that is about to be changed in the name of Jesus. When God step into your matter, all labor that had no results will come to an end. Number three, I want to go fast because I want to pray tonight. Number three, what happened when God is involved? Number three, what happened when God is involved? Number three, number one, I said when God is involved, what happened, sir? Number one, I said result will cancel insult. Number two, I said when God is involved, your toiling and your labor will come to an end. Number three, when God is involved, you become a reference point. You become a what?
A reference point.
Hear me, somebody. When God decides to show up for you, you don't need to advertise yourself. Your testimony will be clear. When God decides to show up for a man, you don't need to be telling people that something has changed. The testimony in your life will be an advert on its own. Jesus met Bartimaeus. Bartimaeus was blind. And even the name of the man, his condition was attached to his name. The man was called Bartimaeus, which means the son of Timaeus. And because of his blindness, even Bible called him
blind Bartimaeus. But when Bartimaeus met Jesus, when Bartimaeus met the man that is more than enough to settle every matter, and that is the man I am introducing to somebody tonight. When he met Bartimaeus, the story of Bartimaeus changed for good. Jesus met a woman whose condition did not allow people to know her name. How do I know? Mark chapter 5 from verse 25. Jesus met a woman that till tomorrow, nobody knows the name of this woman. Bible referred to her as the woman, a certain woman, which had an issue of blood. She had a name, but because of her condition, people forgot her name. There is somebody watching at me. Maybe people are trying to forget your name because of your condition. Maybe people are turning their backs on you because of your condition. Maybe people are being quiet around you because of your condition. There is hope for you, my daughter, tonight. Jesus met the woman. Jesus was not interested in her name. But the Bible said that after she came in contact with Jesus, the flow of blood that had been gone out of her for 12 years instantly dried up. I don't know who is watching at me, that there is an excess bleeding to your life. I don't know why blood is coming out of you excessively, that even before your time you used to be bleeding and you don't like it and it is painful. As I speak to your life tonight, it comes to an end in Jesus' name. Every abnormal flow, it comes to an end in the name of Jesus. She met Jesus and her condition changed for better. Jesus met the crippled man at the pool of Bethesda. Jesus met a man that was in a place for 38 years. 38 years he had been stagnated in one pool, waiting for the moving of the water. Year by year, he will make attempts, and yet nothing will happen. An angel will come annually, once a year, to stir the water. And Bible says, he that will first jump into the water will be cleansed. 38 years had gone. This man was still in the same place, same condition. The reason why your condition is not changing is because the man called Jesus has not yet entered that condition, has not yet entered that situation. And that is why I'm here to introduce that man to you. That's why I'm introducing that man called Jesus to you. When Jesus got to that pool, 38 years problem became a testimony. Can I pray for 49 people watching at me? I don't know what is that condition that is lasting long in your life. I don't know what is that ailment that has been so long and you are trusting God to bring it to an end. I don't know what is that problem of yours that has been with you for so long that you keep asking God, when will it going to end? I come as a prophet of God tonight. I come as an oracle of God tonight. I come as a servant of God tonight. And I pray for you in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I command every pain to disappear in Jesus' name. I command every problem to come to an end in Jesus' name. I command every issue to be quieted around your life in the name of Jesus. When God is involved in your matter, your life becomes a reference point. People will be explaining. They will not end the explanation until they mention your name. When people are talking about the goodness of God, they will not stop talking until your name is being mentioned. I remember the other day, I was preaching and I was trying to explain about the grace of God. And it's like people, we are not trying to understand. And I said to them, if you want to see the grace of God, look at my life. My life is a message of what grace can do. My life is a message of how far grace can take a man. Everything around my life is by the grace of God. When God is involved in your matter, you become a reference point. Things around you will be what people will use to share testimonies to others.
You may not stand before the altar to be telling people, but when a woman is barren, hear this well. Oh, I don't know who this is going from. When a woman is barren and she has been trusting God for a child, when she becomes pregnant, she do not need to tell people that she's pregnant. Give her time. The pregnancy will advertise itself. May your pregnancy advertise your testimony in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And finally, number four, before we pray. Anta lamando kashaya. Oh, kalabashota lamanda. Kala toto lobo godogeya baba. There is somebody watching at me. I can feel the fire all over where you are now. Kalabo seta lamanda. Ika kalabo dodoboshete. Wherever you are, I can feel an angel that is standing right by your side now. And the angel is just waiting to perform that miracle in your life. When God is involved in your matter, when God is involved in your case, finally, number four, the fourth thing that happened, and we pray tonight, when God is involved in your matter, number one, I said, results will cancel insults. Number two, I said, when God is involved in your matter, your toiling and your labor will come to an end. And number three, I said, when God is involved in your matter, you become a reference point. And finally, number four, when God is involved in the matter of a man, you enjoy rest. You enjoy rest. The desire of God is to cause his people to enjoy rest and not to live in stress. There are many people who are dead and gone today. They died before their time because of stress. You cannot serve God and be stressful. He said, cast all your cares unto me. He said, for I will give you rest. He said, for I care for you. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. He said, and I will give you rest. God's desire is to give his people rest. He said, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Take my yoke upon you. Learn of me. He said, for the yoke that I have is easy. He said, and the burden that I give is light. You can't serve God and be full of stress. You can't serve God and be stressful. Oh, my life is so much full of rest. My life is so much full of rest because I know that the God I serve has given me a promise that he came to give me rest. Somebody watching at me, God is going to give you rest.
Amen.
I say, God is going to give you rest.
Amen.
I say, God is going to give your life rest.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, the other day, something happened to the prophet Elisha. I'm ending with this story. Something happened to the prophet Elisha. Bible said that enemies came to attack the God's prophet. Enemies came from everywhere. They surrounded the mountain where Elisha was. And the Bible said that the servant that was with Elisha was shaking. The servant was shaking. Bible said when the servant looked and saw the amount of people that had surrounded the mountain, that we are there because of his master. He was shaking. And he went to his master. And he said to him, alas, master, they are many. They have come and they are too many. I love what Elisha said. Elisha looked at his servant and said, why are you so burdensome? Why is your life so full of stress? And Elisha prayed a prayer. What was the prayer of Elisha? Elisha said, Lord, open his eyes. Not my eyes, because I know that they that are for me, they are more than they that are his. He said, Lord, open this human eye for him to see that we are surrounded by chariots. And the Bible said that when God opened the eyes of the servant, when he saw how many angels encamp around them. Oh, Psalm 125 verses 1 and 2. Bible said, they that trust in the Lord, they shall be as Mount Zion, which cannot be removed, but abideth forever. And verse 2 say, for as the mountain surroundeth Jerusalem, so the Lord is round about his people. Lord, open his eyes to see. And when God showed this man, the man was at rest. There is somebody watching at me. I don't know what is that issue. that has brought so much stress to your life. I don't know what is that thing that you are believing God to do in your life that is causing you to be so much stressful. I am here tonight to encourage you. I am here tonight sent by God to admonish you that you don't need to be stressful. All you need is to involve God in the matter. All you need is to involve God in the matter. When God is involved in your matter, your life will be full of rest. Rest is coming for somebody tonight. I say rest is coming for somebody tonight. Rest is coming for you tonight in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are, rise up on your feet. Rise up on your feet. We want to pray. Four major prayers tonight. We want to pray. Lift up your voice and bless his name. Lift up your voice wherever you are and bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name and say, Lord, we are grateful tonight. We are grateful tonight. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you glory. We are grateful tonight. We are grateful tonight. We give you honor. We give you honor. We are grateful tonight. Let your name be magnified. Let your name be glorified. Let your name be exalted.
We thank you,
Jesus. Come on, somebody bless him. Bless him. Magnify.
Yes, we thank you, Jesus. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you honor.
Let your name be glorified.
Oh, we bless you.
Let your name be magnified.
Come and sound like you, my bless you, Jesus.
Let your name be magnified.
We give you glory. Thank you, Jesus.
Let your name
be glorified. Let your name be glorified. Oh, Shabba, Shika.
Everything I give to you, I surrender to you everything, everything I give to you, withholding nothing.
Come on,
withholding nothing.
Sing the song.
Can you use me? I give myself away. Yeah. I give myself away. So you can use me. I give myself away.
One more time, somebody convert it to a prayer and tell Lord, say, Lord, I give myself to you tonight. I surrender all to you tonight. Everything I give to you tonight, withholding nothing, withholding nothing, withholding nothing, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I give myself away. I surrender all to you. Everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I give you myself. I give you my all. I empty myself to you. Take all of
of me. Take all 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 of me. I give myself. I give myself. I give myself. I give myself. I surrender all. I surrender all. I surrender all. I empty myself unto you. I empty my life unto you. Take all of me. 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 Thank you, Father. Tonight, as I come before you, I give myself away. I surrender all. Everything I give to you. Everything I give to you. Withholding nothing. I withhold nothing. I give it all. After this prayer, there is going to be a shifting in the life of somebody.
Amen.
Something is going to change in the life of somebody.
Amen.
Are you ready to pray with me?
Yes, sir.
The first thing I said to you was that when God is involved, result will cancel insult. That is your prayer. Lift up your hand and your voice and say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Say, my Father, my Fighter.
My Father, my Fighter.
As I involve you tonight,
as I involve you tonight,
into my family matter,
into my family matter,
as I involve you tonight,
as I involve you tonight,
into all of my matter,
into all of my matter,
if my life resolves, that will cancel every insult. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. If my life resolves, if my life resolves, that will bring an end to every insult. Oh God, my Father, let my life carry results. Let my life carry results. Let my life carry results. To quiet my enemies. To silence my opposers. To silence my opposers. To silence my accusers. Give my life results. Give my life results. That will silence insults. That will silence insults. Give my life results. Give my life result. That will silence every insult. Give my life result. That will silence every insult.
Thank you,
Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
The second thing I said to you tonight, I beg somebody watching at me to pray. There is a result that you must demand God to give you. Hear me.
Yes, sir.
Without results, people will not respect you.
Yes, sir.
Listen to me, somebody. We are living in an era that even if you are the eldest in the family, if your life do not have results, nobody will respect you. In those days, respect is by gray hair. Now, respect is by evidence. Without evidence, there is nothing like respect. So when we say pray, I want to beg you to pray. I want to beg you to pray. Prayer point number two. I said to you that when God is involved, your toiling will come to an end. Every fruitless labor. Many of you watching at me, like I said earlier on, the way you are laboring, it cannot be equal to your life. Your life is full of labor, but nothing to show for it. Wake up in the morning, come in the evening. Wake up in the morning, come in the evening. And at the end of it all, so many debts in your head. That is not the desire of God for your life. This is what you are going to say, Lord, as I involve you in my matter. Bring an end to every unnecessary labor.
Bring an end to every
lift up your hand and say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
Very loud, say, my Father, my Fighter.
My Father, my Fighter.
As I pray tonight,
as I pray tonight,
oh God, my Father,
oh God, my Father,
as I involve you,
as I involve you
in my matter,
in my matter,
from tonight,
from tonight,
bring an end
to
every unnecessary labor.
From tonight,
bring an end to every unnecessary toilet. Live my life every day. Lift up your voice and pray that
way. My Father, 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 my Father,
bring an end to every unnecessary labor. Every unnecessary labor.
Bring an end to it.
Every unnecessary labor.
Bring an end to it,
O God.
Bring an end to every unnecessary
labor.
In the name of Jesus.
Give my life evidence.
Give my life evidence.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' name of God.
Amen.
There are four people, as you are praying this prayer now, you know that I am talking to you. There are four people that is watching me now. As we are praying this prayer, as I lifted up this prayer, you said in your heart, that Pastor, Daddy, you are talking to me. You are talking to me. I am laboring, but I have too little to show for my labor. Therefore, I pray for you with all my heart tonight. I don't know where you are watching me from. I don't know where you are watching me from. I don't know how much input you are giving to life, but the result is so few, it's so small. I pray for you today that as God involved in your case and your matter, every unnecessary labor will come to an end in Jesus' name.
Amen.
From today, as he said in his word,
yes,
that
sir,
he will bless the works of our hand.
Yes,
I pray for you watching me that from today, everything you put your hand to do, it will produce results in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It will produce results in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It will produce results in the name of Jesus. And every unnecessary labor will come to an end in the mighty name of Jesus. Second to last, I please beg you not to be bored, not to be tired. Second to last tonight, I said to you that when God is involved, you become a reference point. It's a fearful prayer. It's a dangerous prayer. Lord, make my life a reference point. These are prayers I prayed, and today I am seeing the results in my life. Make my life a reference point. When people are talking of the goodness of God, they must make me a reference point. If it happens to me, it can happen to somebody that is watching at
yes,
me. If only you can pray this prayer with all of your heart. I see God making your marriage a reference point. I see God making your job a reference point. I see God making your home a reference point. I see God making your children's life a reference point. That when they are talking of good children, they will point to your own children.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. Lift up your hand and say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Very strong. Say, my Father, my God.
My Father, my God.
As I pray tonight, from today, I involve you in my matter. In my family matter, I involve you, Lord. In my marital matter, I involve you, Lord. In the matter of my destiny, I involve you tonight. From tonight, oh God, make my life a reference point. Make me a reference point in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer.
Lord,
Lord, from tonight, Lord, make my life a reference. 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 Lata tala madoshiti, iko tala madoshiti, ika lama teka daga 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 ya. When people are talking about the goodness of God, when people are talking about the mercy of God, let my life be mentioned. Let my family be mentioned. In the name of Jesus, make me a reference point. Make my family a reference point. Let my life give hope to people. Let my life give hope to my generation. Make me a reference point. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. Somebody hear me now. This is what I hear God say. God is saying to someone that is watching me now, that what he's about to do in your life, he will use your life to give hope to others.
Amen.
Oh, you didn't hear me well. What God is about to do in your family, in your life,
yes, sir,
it will give hope to the hopeless in the name of Jesus. Amen. When people will see how God would have dealt with you in a positive way, they will know that it's worth it to serve God. May your life give hope to people around you. May your life give hope to your family. May your life give hope to your generation. May your life give hope to your contemporaries. May your life give hope to mankind. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Jesus. Yes, there is a lady watching at me. God said that that is what he's about to do. That is what he's about to do in your life. He will use your life to give hope to your generation.
Yes, sir.
He will use your life to give hope to others around you.
Amen.
That people who thought that serving God is in vain,
yes, sir,
when God would have done that testimony and miracle for you,
yes, sir,
they will come to know that serving God is worth it.
Yes, sir.
Your life will give hope to many.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. This is the final prayer tonight. Finally tonight, I said to you, that when God is involved, you enjoy rest. Somebody say rest.
Yes.
That's one of my prayer, and that's one of the thing God is. That's one of the thing God is helping me with. God has given me rest, marital rest, family rest, ministry rest, many rest God has given to me. And that is the same prayer I'm praying for you tonight.
Yes, sir.
As you are watching me wherever you are.
Yes, sir.
If only you believe in the grace of God that is upon my life.
Yes, sir.
There is somebody watching at me now. The enemy is telling you, don't listen to what he's saying. He's job bragging. God has given me rest. And I pray for you that same prayer.
Yes, sir.
The same God who gave me rest.
Yes, sir.
May he do the same for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May he do the same for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Maritally, may he give you rest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In family, may he give you rest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In ministry or whatever job you are doing, may you enjoy rest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Stretch your hand before you. In fact, that prayer, I'm going to pray it for you. Just stretch your hand in front of you. I am going to pray this last prayer for you. I hear God say, don't let them pray. You pray. You pray as my servant. I will hear you. Lord, yes. I bow my knees upon this altar. And I pray for somebody that is watching. I don't know which area they are trusting you to give them rest. Some of them, it is towards their settlement. They need settlement. They need rest towards their settlement. Some of them, it is towards their childbearing. They need rest when it comes to their childbearing. Some of them, it is towards their finances. Some of them, it is about their traveling. Some of them, it's about their job and their businesses. Some of them, it's about their academic life. Some of them, it's about their health. I pray for all of you tonight. If I am called by God, if I am called by Jehovah, therefore, I pray for you tonight. May God give your life rest in Jesus' name. May God give your life rest in Jesus' name. May God give your life rest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, please give your people rest. As you gave me rest, give them rest. Settle them on every side. 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 May they walk in rest after tonight. May they walk in rest in the name of Jesus. As you show me mercy, show them mercy. As you showed me mercy, show them mercy.
Amen.
Give them what they don't deserve.
Amen.
As you gave me what I never deserved, do the same for somebody watching at me.
Amen.
Do the same for someone that is trusting you.
Amen.
In one area or the other, give them rest. Give them rest. Give them rest. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Let your name be glorified. The Lord will give you rest. Wherever you are, as I touch the phone, I said the Lord will give you rest.
Amen.
As my hand is upon the phone, if you can touch the hand, touch the hand. May God give you rest.
Amen.
May heaven give you rest.
Amen.
May heaven give you rest.
Amen.
May heaven give you rest.
Amen.
On every side, the Lord will settle your life.
Amen.
You will not live a stressful life from tonight.
Amen.
You will not live a life of stress from tonight.
Amen.
May you enjoy divine rest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be for you. Thank you, Father, because it is done.
Thank you, Lord.
Be glorified.
Glorify.
Be glorified. Come on, lift up your voice and bless him. Bless him. Bless him. Bless him, somebody.
You are all that
matters.
Thank you for
you. Lift up your voice and magnify him.
I will make room for two. You are God, Jesus. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. I'll put you in front, in front of my melody. You are all.
I'll make room for two.
Hey.
You.
you put God in front, as you make room for you and Jesus, as Jesus is all that matters to you, may He settle your life for good. May He settle your life for good. May He settle every matter that surrounds your life in the name of Jesus. If Jesus is all that matters to you, then be rest assured tonight that change has come for you. If Jesus is all that matters to you, then be rest assured tonight that He will settle your life. That He will answer that question of yours. That He will solve that puzzle of your life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for what you have done. Let your name be glorified tonight. We are grateful whenever we gather before you. It's a privilege. It's a privilege and a honor to come before you. We don't take your goodness for granted. If not for you, where would we have been? Thank you for eye-opening tonight. Thank you. That if only we can involve you in our matter. If only we can involve you in our matter. Things are bound to change for our favor. Thank you because it is already done. Bless somebody tonight. Oh, I see the joy of somebody leaping up. I see somebody rejoicing in your spirit. I see somebody, the baby in you is leaping for joy. Because something is about to change in your life. Something is about to change in your family. Something is about to change in your destiny. A testimony that will blow the mind of many is about to come your way in the name of Jesus. Thank you for what you have done. Let your name be glorified. Receive all the praise. Receive all the glory. Receive all the honor and adoration. Be exalted forever. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Father, for everything. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord bless you wherever you are. The Lord bless you. We are done for tonight. We keep encouraging you. Please, please, some of these prayers, as God will lead you, if you can pray them again, pray them again. Jesus is all that matters. If only you can involve Him in your matter, everything will come to an end. We know that you are tremendously blessed tonight. Keep the fire burning. Keep being optimistic. Change is very close. Change is very close. Change is not far from you. It is just next to you. And sooner, life will change for better for you. And people will see your testimony and they will know that you have not labored for God in vain. They will come to know that you have not served God in vain. Your life is going to be a reference point that people will use to know that serving God worth it in the name of Jesus. We are grateful having you all the time on this platform. Please connect others. Please share this page with as many as you can. Don't be greedy about it. Don't be greedy. As somebody also told you about this page, you yourself share it with somebody else and be a blessing to your generation. And your life and your family will never be the same. See you on Sunday, 9 o'clock in the morning, 9 a.m. And the Lord will keep us united.
Amen.
Shalom.